Hey, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you the best way to do black and white inside of Photoshop. As you're aware, there's more than one way of doing many things inside of Photoshop, and black and white is one of those. There's multiple ways of creating a black and white image, but I'm going to show you the best way, and I'm going to tell you why it's the best way. First of all, the first way you could do it is to convert it to grayscale. But what you do when you do that is you throw away 2/3 of your information. So you're throwing away 2 of the channels and only keeping 1. So you're losing a lot of information, a lot of detail. Not the best method. The second method, which is sometimes people use, and it's great for doing special effects, to get a quick black and white is to just desaturate the image. You just Command-Shift-U, Control-Shift-U on Windows, or just select image desaturate. Now, that will get you a black and white and maintain the 3 channels, but the problem with that is you get no adjustments. You don't get to choose which areas you would like to have lighter and which areas you like to have darker. So it's a one-trick pony. Not necessarily the best. The third option, which most people are using, is a black and white adjustment. If you're smart, you'll be using it as an adjustment layer because it's much better. But here's the problem with that. That'll give you a lot of control. It'll enable you to bring out the highlights and the shadows wherever you want. But the problem is if you push one of those color sliders too far, it starts to introduce artifacts, and you'll see like this grain and this little kind of noisy thing going on there, and it will degrade the quality of your image if you're not careful. So then the last method, and a method I'm going to show you, actually is a method we've been doing for years, and that's to use Channel Mixer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to create a black and white conversion using the Channel Mixer. And what it does is it uses the actual information in the color channels, so we're not introducing any noise or any problems in there. And we can blend the different channels together to get just the right blend to get the perfect black and white. So let's jump in and have a look at that right now. So here we have an image that we want to convert to black and white. Now we could go under the image adjustments, and under the adjustments here we can find our channel mixer. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply it as an adjustment layer, because it's always a better idea to use an adjustment layer. So just grab the adjustment layers here and we're going to go to channel mixer. Now what channel mixer does, let me just pull the properties up so we can see it on the side here, is it will go into these channels. If we actually look at the image, there's our composite image that we're seeing, the RGB channels. If we look in the red channel, we can see that's the information there. Where it's lighter means there's more of that color. So we can see there's more red here in the rocks and in the trees. If we hit the green channel, this will show us where we are in the greens. Where it's dark means there's an absence of green. Where it's light, there's more green. And as we can tell, that water is pretty greeny. And then if we hit blue, notice there that we can see it's brighter there in the sky, meaning there's more blue in the sky, more blue in the water. And you can see it's very dark over here and in the trees, meaning there's no blue in there. So the point of working with the channel mixer is that we can convert it to monochromatic or grayscale by clicking here on monochrome. Now this converts it to black and white, but the cool thing about it is that we can adjust the red, green, and blue and balance the amount of each one of those color channels to create a better conversion. And you'll notice here that right now by default it's 40, 40, and 20, and a total there is 100. Now you need to be careful not to go too much over 100, because if you do that, then the image will be too bright and it will start to clip. If it stays too low beneath it, then the image is not going to be light enough. Sometimes there's going to be times, obviously, when the image is a little dark or a little light where it doesn't have to reach 100. And we also have the ability to do the constant. So if we mix these and we get a nice mix between the three of them, but it's a little too bright or a little too dark, we can just move the constant. So let's have a look at how this works. Let's look at the sky there with the blue. If I increase the blue, notice I can brighten up that area of the sky. And if I go there, it darkens it down. Obviously, it's affecting the whole image. But look at these areas that don't really have blue, such as these leaves here and these rocks. And some of these little islands here, you'll notice they don't move as much because they're not being affected by blue. And the same thing with the red. If we do the reds here, we can see our rocks there will get a little brighter or darker. And you can see how that affects, you know, like the sky, for example, is not really changing much. So you can see that. So what we're going to do here is I'm just going to reset by clicking there. And we're going to hit our monochromatic again. And in the greens, we can see how our overall greens are affecting everything, particularly in this foliage over here and in these leaves. If we push it a little too high, it can start to look infrared. All right, so we're going to reset this. We're going to hit monochromatic. And now we're gonna have a look at creating our channel mixer. Now what I wanna do is we'll start with our reds. Let's play around with our reds a little bit. I'm kinda liking that. And let's play for our greens. And then our blues, maybe too much blue. We want that blue to lighten up a little bit, but we don't want it to blow it out here. So what happens if we take these reds down? Or the greens, you can see how it's really just changing the overall appearance. So let's find a nice amount of green there. I'm kind of liking how this foliage is looking here. The blues are looking pretty good. Maybe the reds could be brightened up a little bit. Let's just play around with that until we find a nice mix. So now if you look at this, what we've got here is a pretty good overall mix between the three. Now you're just going to want to play around with them a little bit until you get exactly what you want. But notice only 91%, so we can brighten up some areas. If we wanted to brighten up maybe the skies or the blues, we could push that up a little bit more until we get a good adjustment there. So you can kind of see that's what we've got. Now watch for some of these areas that might be clipping. We can fix that by the constant by reducing it, or we can increase it to brighten up certain areas there too. So don't be afraid to use that. I'm just gonna set that back to zero because we don't need it right now. And I'm just gonna give this just a little smidge more into the reds, and I'm gonna pull back the blue just a little bit because I don't want that to clip. So as you can see there, we've got a pretty nice conversion there where we've converted this to black and white, and we've maintained a lot of the detail there. Hey guys, thanks for watching. As you can see, the channel mixer really is the best way to create a black and white conversion inside of Photoshop. If you enjoyed this, hit the subscribe button because I've got new tutorials I'm creating all the time and I'd love for you to have them. Also, don't forget, add a comment, add a like, tell your friends about this, and until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.